everybody, welcome to another episode of the Successful Woman's Mindset. My name is Galit Ventura Rosen. I am co-founder of Everyday Woman TV, a business coach and a commercial real estate broker. One of my favorite things to do in the world is every week bring you an amazing woman that is out there doing things that are making our world a better place. Today, I'm excited to share with you one of our TV hosts, Laura Borland. Welcome, Laura.
Thank you so much, Galit. Super excited to be here.
I'm going to share a little bit about you, and then we're going to jump right into this topic because I know we have so many great things and tips to be sharing with everyone today on how they themselves can use quiet creativity, how to use peace to unleash the windfall of ideas. And it's going to be so much fun. So stay tuned, everybody, if you're listening and watching, because you want to write down these ideas and tips to get your creative juices flowing. So Laura Borland is a founder, author, creator, entrepreneur, TV host, and speaker. She is the host of Gladverse TV, which is on Everyday Woman TV. You can watch her episodes. They're wonderful. I've watched them. She interviews some amazing ladies on her show, as well as the founder of two apps. And these apps are specifically built to help the small business. And more than anything, she lives in Sunrise, Florida, in beautiful Florida. We were just talking about that. I love Florida. It's so beautiful. And she's a journaling coach, which is going to be some of the tips she's going to be giving you today. So, Laura, let's get started. Why quiet creativity? What does that mean?
Well, for the most part, our entire lives are just filled with noise. We live very noisy lives, from, you know, technological stimulation to the barrage of emails, the social media, everything that's happening around us, the news, everything. And so what happens is that our minds become cluttered with other people's ideas, other people's input, as opposed to listening to our inner voice and actually taking the time to just kind of sit still and allow all of the things that make you, you, flow through you. So a big part of being quiet is that you have a barrage of ideas. You always do. And if you ask or write it down of the things that you would like to create, the answers to the questions that you want, it can't happen in an environment with noise. It has to happen when you're sitting still, whether it's through meditation, whether it's through journaling, whether it's just through just being, and the answers will come to you. But it requires that degree of patience, but all of the answers that you're looking for will appear.
So I'm going to share my own experience and also share what people say all the time. Sure. Years and years ago, probably I was introduced to meditation around 11 years ago, maybe. And I'll never forget. I started going to meditation 3 times a week. And I know we're not specifically talking about that, but for me, that's sitting in the quiet. And I remember going for 1 hour, 3 times a week. And it was the hardest thing I ever did in my life. To sit still for 1 hour, because it was like a train wreck in my brain. It was coming and coming and coming. And one of the things that I learned was I didn't want to listen to everything that was coming to me. Mm. So what would be one piece of advice before we jump into how to get into the quiet creativity? When someone says, Laura, I don't like what I hear or what comes into my brain when I sit in quiet?
Well, I'll share something that I do in journaling that has helped me tremendously. I also have the doubts that pop into my mind as to whether or not I'm doing this correctly, whether or not I'm feeling the positive effects of it, and also trying to get out of my head all of those things that are weighing down on my energy. Yeah. So we have to start with a practice of complimenting yourself. So every day we're showing up and we're doing amazing things. But what we do often is that we give gratitude towards other people, but we're not in the business of praising ourselves. So think about how you started this day, Galit. Think about how many lives you've probably impacted already. Think about just you showing up and just being that badass, pardon my language, but just the way you're killing it in life, and just pat yourself on the back. It gives you that moment of pause to realize that all of this, all of you, that positive light being that you are, is so powerful. And therefore, it allows you to just kind of put a smile on your face, push away that negative thought for a moment, and focus on what it is that you want. So every day, when I do my end of day journaling, and even when I start my day, first things first, when I wake up in the morning, the first thing I do is like, I say yes three times and I welcome the day.
Beautiful.
Next thing that I do, and then when I go to bed at night, when I do my journaling, it starts off with, today I am so proud of myself for doing X, Y, Z.
How many people don't do that ever? Forget every day, ever say, I'm so proud of myself. I did a really good job. And you know what else I found, Laura? Some women, because we're conditioned to not pat ourselves on the back, will say things, I feel like I did such a great job today, but, or
comma,
I don't want to brag about myself, but I, instead of just saying, I'm awesome, right? And energy, look at the energy, how different it was when I said, well, I did a good job today, but, or I'm awesome. And I will tell you that my own experience with quiet creativity has been a journey, because I went from the train wreck of the things that would not stop coming into my mind. And it wasn't doubt. It was things I didn't want to listen to about my life, things I didn't want to listen about, the things I was unhappy about. This was 11, 12 years ago. And I didn't want to listen. And it was hard work. But when I finally started listening to that inner voice and almost like checkmarking the boxes and writing it down, today, I don't have that anymore. I don't have that. When I sit in pin drop quiet, which is every single day, it's peace. It's quiet. Let's jump in. Start giving them some ideas and tips of how they, those that are listening and watching, can tap into their own quiet creativity.
Sure. Okay. So I want to just honor what you just said.
Please.
Because it is a journey, right? It took a while for me to get out of the past living state. So bringing up things that happened 12, 15 years ago that have nothing to do with the person that I am. It has informed who I am today, but it's not the person that I am now. So I live in 24-hour gaps. That's how that works. I do future intentions. So in the sense that the first thing I do, I pat myself on the back today, I'm proud of myself for tomorrow, comma, I want to be more expansive. I want to learn more. I want to.
I love that.
Yeah. So you future set your life, okay, right? You go to bed with a lot clearer, with a lot more clarity. Your dreams are better, and you're just unleashing. The second thing I would tell you is that in that quiet moment, you want to, if you're journaling, this is something I choose to do, because journaling is powerful in the sense that it allows you to put it in, like etch it on your brain, right? Okay. That movement of writing allows for it to be really intentional as to what it is that you're doing. I mean, think about it. When you're in school, the people who took notes did better, right? So your hearing is not enough. You're writing it down and making an active effort to put into words all of this chaos, all of these thoughts as an outlet is powerful. But I would tell you that to get the best effects out of journaling or trying to unleash that creativity is to keep it short.
Okay.
The reason is that when you start to write, the brain likes to balance things out. So when you start writing about positive things, the however comma comes in.
Okay.
Okay. So you go, oh, this was a fantastic day. And, you know, I'm so grateful, you know, that Galit has me on for this interview, comma. Mm-hmm. But it wasn't that great because, like, I kind of stuttered and blah, blah, blah. We don't want the negative to creep in. Okay. So you do it intentionally to just focus on the positive and only do like 5 quick intentions. But then you always want to future-proof your work. So tomorrow I want the creative ideas. And I just want to share something with you too that occurred while for every creative endeavor I've had. I remember how I even started Glum to Glad. My journal series was because on Facebook, I got kind of tired of seeing a lot of people just stuck in grief. like every day was like, you know, rest in peace, mom. It's been 20 years. It still feels like yesterday. And it just felt like this ongoing place of mourning. And I know how powerful journaling has been for me. It was very therapeutic when I had to process the loss of my best friend. And one night I'm like, you know, I wrote down, I wonder how I can help. And I kid you not, clear as day, like it woke me up out of my sleep, was like the brightest light. It was just, it just said bereavement. And I'm like, what? You know, like I hadn't even thought about that space, hadn't thought about anything like that. But within a day, I took what I knew as a quality engineer and what I took as a teacher and created an evidence journal series so you could know if you're doing better over time. Ooh. And really just, yeah, and setting up a 40-day protocol. Everything has come to me in that quiet. If I've asked for it, if I've written it down and asked a specific question, yeah. Being called to your show, you popped into my timeline because I asked for more visibility.
Yes.
I wanted, you know, people like you who think macro, people like us, we think macro, right? We are in the business of uplifting. And when you're in the business of uplifting, you have to find macro platforms to do that, right? Because you want to reach maximum reach because you're doing the work of elevating. And when you're elevating people, you need to get as many as you can because we have no time for just the one-on-one. It's important. Yeah, you do the one-on-one, but I'm telling you, what I've found to be the most effective is really spending time putting it out there and understanding that not everyone will get it right away, but the person who needs to hear your message at that particular time will find you.
Yes.
And your message will resonate with just that one. And even if it just resonates with just one, you know you've created that outlet, right? In that role of service. Mm-hmm. In the role of service, in order to bring humanity and to elevate humanity.
One person at a time, right, Laura? One person at a time. Because it's not even really about one person at a time. It's about we don't know what that one person's impact is going to be.
True.
So how many times have you gotten a message? I know you've experienced it as well. I have, where I'll get a message from someone that's been watching me from a distance and says, hey, Galit, I just want you to know because of your videos, I just wrote my book. And because I wrote my book, because of that, and it just keeps going. It's this domino effect. And you don't even know who you're impacting. So someone watching or listening right now could be impacted by you, Laura. You'll never know.
True.
And then they go and they do something impactful to help and serve other people. And that domino effect continues. So even though it's one person, it really isn't. It becomes this effect that just grows. So you're absolutely right. I love that you said that. I also love that you recognize that the intention is set and you know what you're looking for, and then it shows up. It happens to me all the time. People that don't get it think you're nuts, but something will come in the mail and I'll be like, oh my gosh, look at this check that just came in the mail. Yes, checks come in the mail. And I get a check and I'll start crying. And my boyfriend will be like, honey, what is going on? I go, you don't understand. I totally forgot about this.
Absolutely.
And it could be even something like a refund. It happened to me, Laura. I overpaid my HOA fees by $3,200, not even knowing it.
Oh my God.
It was an auto pay. And I was paying monthly instead of quarterly, and they sent me a check. And I looked at the statement. I'm like, oh my gosh. So I went in, of course, and fixed it. But I cried because you never know.
I love windfalls.
Money specifically for my child for something. And it was just this experience. And it's not even that you don't have the money. It's what a neat thing that I just got done saying, okay, I need this. And then boom. So I love, and I will, one more thing that you said that's so impactful. Your best ideas come in the quiet.
It does.
I want people to hear that. Your best idea. And this is not just Laura making this up. That's been my experience as well. Yeah. Everyday Woman TV came to me in the quiet.
The same thing with my book, Adversity. Like even the name of the book, right? The whole idea of overcoming adversity with gladness, right? And just creating that term and looking at Gladverse TV and saying, this is how I want I want my media empire to be this. And I'm putting that into motion with the idea that I am deserving of that. I have worked hard and I have enjoyed the process. And I also believe, Billy, that your channel, your concept is going to be huge. Because it's
Laura, we do too.
I love it.
Angela and I have been self-funding this for over 2 years.
Love
and
it.
We said, we just had a meeting yesterday. We meet 3 times a week. And we said, we know sometimes everybody listening really hear this. Not always everything shows up in the time frame that you want it to.
For sure.
So don't give up. Be patient. If something feels right, don't stop.
You said that.
So the Everyday Woman TV is a perfect example of that. Who the heck starts this crazy channel in the midst of everything going on now? We just know, and we know. And like Laura just said, all right, Galit, apparently you need to hear this. And she didn't say those words, but it was kind of, this is going to be huge.
Yeah, I just know it. And I'm so glad that I'm sitting
in your life.
Yeah, I'm sitting at the pioneering edge of that.
And yes,
it's empowering to watch you grow.
Yeah.
It's empowering to watch you guys grow. And I admire not only that, too, the premise of it feels right. It feels honored.
Yeah.
And that, I think, in itself is incredibly powerful, because just even looking at, the whole concept of just starting this channel, how we happen to find each other. It just resonates with me. And not only that, too, like you mentioned about trusting what you feel. Our intuition is much more powerful than you think. Recently, there's a woman, Dr. Lara Romero, who mentioned this whole thing about writing a question to yourself, right? What would it look like if I were to have my TV station? But just put that in, right? My own television channel. And, you know, just start to write like some good things that would come out of it. If you're finding some hesitancy in terms of like finding good reasons, it's your intuition speaking to you and saying, this might not be the right thing for you. And it was crazy because I asked myself two separate questions about like, where is going to be my next part of my journey, right? 5 years from now, where I'm going to be. And everything flowed. Mm-hmm. And then I asked a question about a specific area of my life and I could not find one thing. I swear, energetically, I could not even move a pen. I could not even think of 3 or 4 things that I want. And I hadn't realized how incredibly powerful this center, this soul is. It was a humbling experience. It was new. I'd never, tried anything like that. And I'm talking about like a month ago, but it shook me to the core. Like I knew I trusted my instincts on a lot of things, but I didn't realize how much our inner core is guiding us. And if we choose to look at that light and we choose to honor that, I think the world becomes our oyster.
And you know, I want us to wrap up and I want you to share about how people can get a hold of you.
Sure.
And what you do and all of that so they can learn more. But what I wanted to share real quick is it's sometimes the scariest thing in the world. And when you first get started on that journey, you don't always want to listen to the quiet creativity. You don't always want to listen to the thoughts that come through your mind. But what I now recognize is I had to go through that to make the space for the creativity.
Love that.
Once I started sitting with myself and allowing the thoughts I didn't want to hear, working through those thoughts and understanding what parts of my life did I need to fix, change. And sometimes it's not even that big of a deal. It's just, okay, I'm not happy because I don't spend more time with my friends. It could be the silliest things,
right?
But they're so impactful. Now you're leaving room for what Laura said, which is that quiet creativity and that ideas that start coming. Guys, make sure you have a pen. Make sure you can talk into your phone. Because sometimes it happens when you're driving. Sometimes it happens when you're out in the middle of nowhere. Make sure, because later you're going to kick yourself because you'll forget the idea that came to you.
So true.
It never fails. Oh my God, I had the best idea. What was it?
So true.
Don't allow fear to be the reason that you don't, because you will never know how amazing that idea can be and what it could turn into. And by the way, some of them are going to fail. Some of them are going to succeed. That's
absolutely
just, right, Laura. It's just part of
absolutely. And just one last thing I want to give to your viewers before I give them my information.
Yeah.
There are a couple of words we need to lose from our vocabulary. Humility is one. That humble and humility stuff needs to go. Okay. We've been preconditioned to have this as part of our experience, like making our, so humble is a derivative of humiliation. So you're making yourself small. You're dimming your light. You're muting the essence that is you. So how different it is when we're like, I am proud of myself. I am killing it in this world. I'm doing amazing things. I am as big a light as I need to be, right? Impacting it out, you know, clearing the darkness and just really being a lighthouse for the world. And if we start getting away from this whole idea of what we've been preconditioned to do, which is like, don't gloat on yourself. You won that race. Don't be running around, you know, pumping your fist, whatever the case is, to show that you are proud of what you've accomplished. That somehow that's a bad thing. And it's not.
Yeah.
Honor yourself. I can't even begin to tell you, self-care and self-love comes first. Everybody else is background noise. Seriously. You first. And then worry about everybody else. So I know you wanted to kind of wrap this up, but I have a website called glumtoglad.com. And that is where I have my journaling, my coaching opportunities, where I take you through a journaling protocol to get over any major adversity that you're going through, whether it be movement or breakups or the blues, or you just want to build your confidence, right? And I also have tailor-made programs as well that can deal with brand rebuilding, reloving your brand. You know, sometimes as a small business, you kind of get, especially if you're bootstrapped, you're just like, oh my God, I can't do this anymore, right? But we need to find, reclaim that joy, that excitement that initially brought you on that journey to pursue your entrepreneurial ideas. And how best can you do that? By just really treating your business as you would like that person, that entity, that energy that you put into it, finding that love again, that passion, so that you can attract the kinds of clients and the business that you want. So
I love that. That's a great way to end the interview today. And also, Laura, you're on social media under your name?
Yes.
Perfect. So, and which ones are you on so people can find you?
Mainly Facebook. I don't understand Instagram.
Laura, we'll talk about that on another. We'll talk about that on another thing. We always say become the queen of one social media, and then
tackle
another because it becomes a lot. But yes. Facebook, they can find you on Facebook, and then are you on LinkedIn as well?
I am under quite a number of names, so I can like Gladversity is one for the name of my book.
Perfect.
I also have just Laura Borland as well, so you can find me.
Perfect. And they'll check out your website as well. And I appreciate you being a guest today. Thank you for taking the time to share Quiet Creativity. What a great topic. And I appreciate everybody watching and listening today on the TV network as well as on my podcast. My name is Galit Ventura-Rosen, and I am with the Successful Woman's Mindset. And we will see you next time. Bye, guys.